NerdDice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 37 in our series, Create a RubyGem, NerdDice. And in this episode, we're going to start chipping away at this ability to inspect individual dice and take actions on them issue, which is over here in the right. So we're going to start by writing specs for our die class. So we'll go into our console here, or terminal. Make sure we check out master. And then we'll create a new branch. Feature die object. So we've got our new branch. Now take a look at the other object that we've written specs for so far. So we've got the configuration spec. So we're going to put that similarly. We're going to have a die spec now in this nerd dice folder. Got our spec, and we'll just copy what we've got for configuration as a model. Our class is NerdDieDie, and default new. So we always have to provide a number of sides. We'll make a d20 here. And now our statements. So we'll I'll pause and write the it statements for what we want for the general class here. So we've written out the unimplemented version of our specs here. So instantiation with options, with no options, with options, and then a roll method. So we'll get going on actually implementing these. So at our, we don't want to name this config, we want to name it die. Thank you. quickly the syntax on being between. We added in the execute die roll method here. So let's see if we can get some failing specs here. Initialize constant, which we know is the case. See how angry RuboCop is with us. Okay, so just RuboCop's happy. We've so I think I want to make this part of the NerdDice level configuration rather than just a constant in the class, but we'll again do the bare minimum to make it pass, and then we'll do some refactoring once we've got that. So I wonder if you can do subject in a right now we have at least the generator override. And then more options as things go on, but that will at least tide us over. So we've got that. Let's and so in this case options. Let's make a block. And then So now we're going to take a look at our last method. Changed equals false. I think I can just do 20 dot times actually. So change will be true, set to true if value not equal to original value. After 20 times, this will happen at least once. And then expect. Trouble with the RuboCop police by doing this, but so. Many expectations. Do it fewer times. And then do a separate if statement for just for the sake of being different, we'll make this a D12. All right. is too many lines. Game. If that roll. Actually, we do want it to return the value that it's rolling. And we want to assert that it will be different. That solves our useless assignment variable. Still in the situation where now we can't have more than one expect. Also considered bad form to make this an instance variable. Stick with this and do an ignore on the line length metric is the best solution. Many lines. So, oops, we did have one other line length example. So we'll implement the same situation here. The name of our spec is our spec example length. And then at the end, we enable it. All right, so RuboCop is not taking us to jail anymore. We've got, I think, the basics down enough so that we can try implementing the class to make these pass, and we'll commit our current state of this. Actually, I'll hold off. Well, yeah, we'll squash it later. We'll just do a quick commit. Which we'll modify the message of later. And we'll stop there, and we'll pick up implementing the class in our next video.
Thanks for watching this Stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.